All right. I went ahead and put the two little white dots for the eyes in here. Okay. And then we'll put, now, I want to, once again, I want to take my black, and I change, you see, I changed my water too. You have to do that every once in a while. I'm going to take my black, and I'm going to water it down real good. And I'm going to go over this area again with the black, okay? There we go. Where it will just have the white showing through. Just go ahead and get that a little heavier. There we go. It just gives it that tint of stuff through there. Just gonna hit that one more time. Okay, now I want to take my black and I want to take my very small brush and I want to, hold on just a second. Take it, and I want to take the black, and I want to put my very small brush in there, and I just want to barely hit the ends of the toes there, like that. Just to signify. That's all. Just like that. All right. Now, I will take my so that I don't this is kind of a golden, this is a golden, oh, this is raw sierra, I'm sorry, that's for raw sienna, and I want to put a little bit of that, water down a little bit of raw sienna, just like that, and I want to take it and I want to put it over just very lightly, hit it over the yellow. So it isn't just a bright, bright yellow. Just like that. So you've got the yellow in the background and you've got the raw sienna. Okay, just like that, see? Where it's not just a bright, bright yellow. Okay, now let me take my put a little bit more black right in this area right here. There we go. Now I want to take my Payne's Gray. Let me put some of this stuff back in. And I want to take my little push pin. Let me get where I can get to it. There we go. Now look. There you go. All right. Now, one more thing. I want to take just a little bit also of raw sienna and just hit highlights on this gray here, just to give it kind of a brown look where it's not so just gray. Kind of a got a little mixture of colors there where it's got kind of a okay. Now, as far as the painting is concerned, it is finished. At which case, I will let it dry, and I will go out and I will put it in the antiquing solution, which is very, very simple. I have the antiquing solution. I do not take it into the house, so I will not do that in the house at all. I'll take my antiquing solution, which I have on my blog, Flat Plane Carver, the mixtures, and I will dip it into the antiquing solution and let it dry for at least 24 hours, and I will have my figure then. And it will smooth those colors out, and he will have an aged look to him, and that's what I want. That's what I want. As you can see right now, as you look at it, the antiquing solution will deepen the colors, yet smooth out the colors as well. And so that is the painting. It's not real difficult. I know there are a lot of people that could probably do paint a lot better than I do, but I like my figures to look old. I don't like a bright color. And with the antiquing solution, it miles the colors even more, and you've got your buzzard. Okay? All right. Well, that's the painting of our buzzard, and then I'll show you after the antiquing solution. And folks, somebody asked me, said, well, what do you do? I mean, it's not nothing special. You mix the antiquing solution, as I have on my blog, and as I've told you before, and once you mix it, then you dip. You just go out there and dip this in it, and wipe off excess and let it dry for at least 24 hours before you spray it with anything. Do not spray it. You must let it. It depends on people. If it's cold or something, it's different. Maybe 2 days, but you let it dry thoroughly, and then I spray it with a little Deft, and that is through with it. So that is our products there. Sorry. And that is the painting. So God bless you now. Thank you so much. And that is our project.